talk about jewels, do you? Fools, listen to music, or do you just skim through it? See, I'm influenced by the ghetto you ruined. The same dude, you gave nothing. I made something new, and what I do through and through, and I give you the news with a twist of just his ghetto point of view. You renegade, you been afraid. I penetrate pop culture, bring them a lot closer to the block where they rock toasters, and they live with their moms, got dry roasters. From watch robberies, niggas crashed over. Mommy's knocked up, cause she wasn't watched over. Knocked down by some clown when child support knocked. No, he's not around. Now, how that sound till you jot it down? I bring it through the ghetto without riding round, hiding down, loving strays from frustrated youth stuck in their ways. Just read a magazine that fucked up my day. How you rate music that thugs with nothing relate to it? I help them see they wait through it, not you. Can't step in my pants, can't walk in my shoes. But everything you work, you lose your tie, your shirt.
I'm in a position to talk to these kids and they listen. I ain't no politician, but I kick it with them a minute. You see, they call me a menace. And if the shoe fits, I wear it. But if it don't, then y'all will swallow the truth, grin and bear it. Now who's the king of these rude, ludicrous, lucrative lyrics? Who could inherit the title? With the youth and hysterics, using his music, his spirit, sharing his views and his merits. But there's a huge interference. They're saying you should inherit. Maybe it's hatred I spew. Maybe it's food for the spirit. Maybe it's beautiful music I made for you to just cherish. But I'm debated, disputed, hated, and viewed in America as a motherfucking drug addict. Like you didn't experiment.
Well, you know, that's when you start to stare at who's in the mirror and see yourself as a kid again. And you get embarrassed. Then I got nothing to do but make you look stupid as parents. You fucking do good. It's too bad you couldn't do good in marriage. And do you have any clue what I had to do to get here? I don't think you do. So stay tuned and keep your ears glued to the stereo. Cause here we go.
He's drinking chicken. I'm the sinister.
Well, you know, my ass is just a renegade. You know, just being in jail together, what's on some of the guys that I used to get on all the time, Larry Brown and Shante Cobb, really proved themselves today, and I think that this team is really growing up a lot.
You're playing your fifth Super Bowl ring, and you have also flirted with the idea of possibly calling it quits. Have you played your last professional football game?
You know, what's going to happen is, you know, I'm going to go to Hawaii, hang out a while, then come back. And I got to talk to the doctors. I got to find out exactly what's going to happen if I keep going. You know, like I said, it did get a little bit sore. You know, I'm 32 years old. I got a little pass. I'm in bed to play with my kids and stuff down the road. But this is something I love. If there's a chance of me playing, then I'll follow up.
Charles, 5 Super Bowl rings is nothing to sneeze at. Congratulations to you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Plenty more coming your way from the Dallas Cowboys locker room. The Cowboys, 27 to 6.
Season. That was 2 years ago as the first down.
Well, see, it's a good call here by the Steelers. They don't have to run inside. What they do, they bring the receiver down inside. Watch him. He's supposed to crack on the Shante Culver 96. He doesn't do it. Eric Deegan does a good job of changing instead of going outside, cutting back inside.
Don't lose your grip on the dreams of the past. You must fight.
the top.